Hello friends and welcome back to the channel. As you can see, today I am outside to go test and review this fantastic power station. Its name is Foxyboat F2400. It is available in two colors, total black or green, and you can also buy various accessories such as in this case the solar panels. A really useful accessory because it allows you to recharge it continuously if you use it, for example, outside. This review, I have divided it into three parts. In the first part, we will analyze all its technical characteristics. In the second part, we are going to do an in-depth look at the operation of solar panels, and in the third part, we are going to do all the charging tests of both my computer, cell phone, my YouTuber equipment, and also recharge the compressor and try to make my lawnmower work electric also, because as you can see from the ground here, I have some uncultivated grass, and being very far from my home, I do not have an outlet that reaches this area. So we are going to use this beautiful generator as a power source for the lawnmower and before leaving. To say with the technical specifications, I remind you that if at the end of the video you will be interested in this fantastic power station, you leave the direct link to be able to buy both in the first comment and in the description of this video. Here we also find the button that is used to turn on the bright LED, and you can also activate the SOS mode in which LED will go intermittently. Above LED light, we find the display, which is also big enough that provides us with all the information. As for the slots, I immediately noticed with pleasure that they are all protected with protective rubber bands, and I appreciate this very much because it protects all the slots from dust. On the left side we find the 12 volt, the classic 10 amp cyber ignition, and on the other side we find the 12. Below we find two classic DC 12 volt and 3 amps, also well protected, and to activate this dial you just have to press this button, and in the left side we find the on and off button above the writing power, the incoming charge regulator, you can adjust the watts. As for the charging of this generator, the brand recommends keeping it to a minimum if you have no particular needs. If you are in a hurry, you can set it to a maximum of over 1100 watts to decrease drastically. Mind the accessory charging times, which as far as I am concerned is really very useful that all devices should have, because being able to adjust the charging speed allows you to significantly extend the life of the power station. As for the charging speed, if you go to knock it to the maximum and connect it to the power outlet, you can recharge from 0 to 100% in just 2 hours. Here we find all the USB ports. Let's start with the upper ones, which are the classic USB ports type AOC 3.0. We have two, one on the right and one on the left. In the central part, we find two classic slots of type C, both 20 watts, and in the lower part, we find a beautiful surprise because here too, we find two slots of type C, which is now the connector that is most used on the market, but one of the two is precisely the one on the left. It has a charge of 100 watts, really very useful if you have mobile phones with fast charging. On the two sides, we find two doors. The upper one is used to let the air escape from the cooling fans and is highly recommended. Keep them open when using the power station. This door is very important because here you will find the slots to recharge the generator. On the right side, you will find the slot for solar panels with this yellow connector with which you can recharge the generator through the solar panels. And on the opposite side, we find the second door with the other two cooling fans and the AC power button for the other three power outlets. And as you can see from the writings, are the classic German sockets from 16 amps and 250 times. And last but not least, I want to show you the resistance of these two handles that are used to lift and move it when you go to use it, and are also fundamental because its total weight is around 22 kilos. And last but not least, the hatch that is present at the top of the power station is almost a Harry Potter style hidden compartment. Inside you can store all the power cables, including its charging cable to connect to your home system. But that's not all, because you can also recharge it via the car plug. So if you have a camper and keep it in your trunk while you are traveling, you can also recharge it. And last but not least is the cable that is used to recharge through the solar panels. And among other things, I also put to recharge all my YouTuber equipment. Here's the power bank, my cell phone list, 360, and this is my laptop that I use outdoors to directly download all the material I record from my cameras. As you can see, the computer is charging and it is already over 90%. I plugged it in. Mind at the power station, this is its charging plug. Now I'm going to reinsert it, but not only because I connected, as I told you, my cell phone, the power bank, and also list 360. And also look at the charging speed of my power bank. I put it under charge when it was at 20%. And thanks to the USB Type-C port with a charging power of 100 watts, it recharged almost completely in less than 20.05. So if you are YouTubers, vloggers or travel lovers, I really recommend this power. Not because you can bring all the equipment without having the slightest worry, always remaining connected. And if you also buy solar panels, you can go in a loop because now both cell phones and computers consume very little, so you can stay even many days, if not a month, without thinking about the boring and annoying problem of charging your devices. And the interesting thing is that the display in the generator also shows the watt consumption for charging.
With AI 2930 watts to charge both the computer, the power bank and my camera also gives you the battery percentage and watts in input. If by chance you connect it to the solar panels, it also tells you exactly, I hope you can see from the camera, the slots that are occupied for charging. And in this video, I want to combine the useful with the enjoyable. In addition to checking if this generator is able to recharge the compressed air of this compressor, let's inflate the tire of this trolley that, as you can see, is completely on the ground. Let's proceed with the inflation.
And here we are that our tire is again charging ball, and now we go to connect the compressor cable to our power station. You have seen it is charging completely, so I have to say that as far as power is concerned, it is approved, and here are the charging data. As you can see, it is absorbing 973 watts, and from the solar panels at the same time, it is charging 231 watts. So I have to say that
they help a lot to further increase the power station. And now, since you are a very demanding audience, let's check if this beautiful power station is able to power my 1600 watt lawnmower. I will go to cart about 50 square meters of garden, and we will see at the end of the cart how much it will have consumed, and above all, how much the solar panels will have helped the generator to compensate for the loss of energy. This power station is at 100%, and I am really curious to know how much battery percentage it will remain after using the mower. And in addition to cutting the grass from the edge of my garden, we will also go mowing in the gravel area to remove these pesky weeds that have infested me. This whole area, which should theoretically be grass-free, I've already hooked up the extension cord to the power station, and now let's go get the high end, hook it up to the lawnmower and see if it can get it to turn on or not. Are you ready? You hear how it's spinning? Let's go see. Even the instant consumption is consuming about 500 watts.
Cutting of the back of the garden completed. Now let's see how much we've consumed. Look at the generator is at 98%. Thanks to the solar panels, it consumed only 2%. Among other things live, we went to 99. So I have to say that these solar panels really have a recharging force not indifferent, and you will use this Fossibo F2004 combined with the solar panels to cut about 50-60 mAh. Of garden will consume only 2%. They also cut a garden of 1,000-1,500 mAh without having the slightest concern that the power bank discharges during cutting. Perfect to be positioned to cut in areas where you have no possibility to connect it to the home plug. And always talking about solar panels, I want to show you how practical and convenient they are to store once finished using them.
And finally, I conclude this review by talking about the price. This fantastic Fossibot F2400 is sold on the official website at 789 euro. And for its features, its power and the amount of slots of this generator is really a great value for money. But I will tell you more because currently there is also a fantastic discount coupon of 90 euro. So if you buy it before the promotion expires, you will pay only 699 euro. So I recommend if you are interested.
You should take advantage of it, and I left you the link to be able to buy. Both in the first comment and in the description of this video, is always in description, you will find links to all accessories, including also solar panels with more watts or less watts. You can easily choose the model that comes closest to your needs. I hope this review has been useful to you by Lucata, that from this beautiful Fossibo F2400 is everything. I salute you and see you in the next video. Hello.